have already discussed things in the magnetic effects of current, like Biot-Savart's law we have discussed. We have discussed the Ampere circuital law. Today we have to discuss about the magnetic force. Whenever we are having a current carrying conductor with us, of course we have already discussed that whenever charge is there, moving charge is producing the electric current. And so whenever a current carrying conductor is there, then of course magnetic field is produced. And we have already discussed whenever magnetic field is produced in a current carrying conductor, I can use this right hand rule with me to find the direction of the magnetic field. Like if the thumb is pointing in the direction of current, then the fingers in which the direction in which they curl, that gives me the direction of the magnetic field. So magnetic field is there produced because of a current carrying conductor. This much we have discussed in the previous class, and that we can find by using the right hand rule, right hand screw rule, or your Maxwell screw rule, or right hand thumb rule. Both the rules, either of them can be used to find the direction of the magnetic field. Now what Lorentz said, he did many experiments to find that whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in the magnetic field, then what happens, that a force is experienced. And that force, whatever is experienced on a moving charge in the magnetic field, that is termed as magnetic force. So this force is magnetic force because it was given by the scientist Lorentz. So it is termed as Lorentz magnetic force. So your topic today is, we have to talk about the magnetic force in detail because of the current carrying conductor. Now if you see this diagram, if I'm having I'm in the XY plane supposedly, then the magnetic field is in this direction as shown in the X direction, and this is the direction which is making some angle, which is the direction of the current, or the conventional current we are taking, and theta is the angle between them. So this is the velocity with which the charge is moving. Direction of the velocity is given, and the theta is the angle between V and B. So what happens now, you have to find the direction of the magnetic force, and it was observed by the Lorentz that this magnetic force is dependent upon this magnitude of the charge. It depends upon the velocity and sine component of the magnetic field. It means perpendicular component of the magnetic field is the direction where the force is acting. So this n cap is the unit vector which is perpendicular to the plane consisting of V and P. And this n cap is giving you the direction for the force. Now how to find the direction of the force? That is of course important. We are going to discuss that in detail. That is obviously given by Fleming's left hand rule, or you can even find by the right hand rule. We are going to discuss in the coming slide. This is simply to talk about the magnitudes of the force. Magnitude of the force you can write, it is directly proportional to the charge, it is directly proportional to V, it means the speed, and it is directly proportional to B sine theta. This is if I talk about the magnitude of the Lorentz magnetic force. Now, of course, before going into direction, firstly, we are talking about the units of the magnetic field that can be taken from this formula. Already we have discussed the SI unit of magnetic field is your Tesla, 1 Tesla, can be taken from this formula. That is, when the maximum value of the force is there, when theta will be equals to 90 degrees. Then the maximum value you can write, F it is equals to QVB. So B will be equals to F upon QV, means force upon charge into velocity. And if you work out, you will be getting 1 Newton per ampere meter. And From here, if you wish, you can define the one Tesla is the force of one Newton when applied, when charge is a unit and the velocity is also unit. 1 meter per second velocity and one Coulomb charge is there, then the magnetic field here will be equals to one Tesla. And of course, you can find the dimensional formula also from here. So basically, whenever it comes to write the dimensional formula of the magnetic field or the unit, this is the basic formula with you, which is to be taken into your mind. To find the dimensional formula is coming out to be mt minus 2 a minus 1. And of course, if you see that charge is at rest, it means v is 0. When v is 0, then of course, from this formula, you can say that no magnetic force will be there. It means a stationary charge in the magnetic field is not experiencing any force. And if theta is 0 or 180, it means charge is moving, but it is moving parallel to the magnetic field, or it is moving anti-parallel to the magnetic field, then also force will be 0. And if theta is 90, it means if charge is moving perpendicular to the magnetic field, charge is moving perpendicular to the magnetic field, then only the force is coming out to be maximum. And for this, to find the direction of force, you have to take Fleming's left hand rule. It means you have to hold the first finger, the central finger and the thumb in the perpendicular direction to each other. And if your first finger is giving you the magnetic force, second finger is giving you the direction of the electric current, then thumb points in the direction of the force. Magnetic force is given by the direction of the thumb. So it is very important. So if central finger, forefinger and thumb, they three are kept perpendicular to each other in such a way that magnetic field is given by the first finger, current is given by the second finger, then thumb will point in the direction of the magnetic force. Or the another way with you is, you can even go with the right hand palm rule also. There, if you hold your right hand like this, it means this your these fingers means this is giving you the magnetic field, thumb is giving you the electric current, then the force is given by the direction of the palm. This is known as right hand palm rule. So either of these two rules you can use to find the direction of the force. Force means magnetic force I am talking about. So you have to find the direction of the magnetic force either by the left hand rule or by the right hand rule, your choice. But standard with us is left hand rule. So Fleming's left hand rule we have to keep in our mind. But if you are comfortable with the right hand rule, you can always find. At the end, the direction which you give should be correct. So if you are not able to find the correct direction of the force, then your result will not be correct in the numericals or in the your conceptual questions. So the direction should be very, very clear in your mind and you should be able to find it correctly. That is important. Now what it is that if a charge is moving with velocity v, supposingly, in the region in which both fields are there, electric field is there as well as magnetic field is there, then Lorentz said that the total force which will be acting on that charge will be equal to the sum of the electrostatic force and magnetic force. So Fe plus Fm, you can write Fe, we have already studied in the previous chapter, that is given by Q into E. And in magnetic field, the value of the force is Q cross B. So these both the things should be clear. So this combined formula is basically used to find the work done, and the basically if we have to go with the principle of cyclotron, then we use this formula when both the fields we are applying, electric field as well as magnetic field, and we are making a charged particle to move in that case, yours both the forces will be added, of course, in the vector form only. So you have to write these both are vectors. Fe is also a vector, Fm is also a vector. So vector sum will be giving you the resultant force. But of course, now cyclotron is not in the syllabus, or if you want to still discuss, we can discuss in the coming lectures. So you keep this thing that whenever a body, a charged particle is moving with velocity v, in which both fields are there, electric field and magnetic field, then the total force will be sum of the electric and magnetic forces, vector sum of the electric and magnetic forces. So it can be written as QE plus Q V cross B. V cross B, again it is giving you VB sine theta, as we have discussed. So that is the sine component of B. Now the thing is, we want to find the force on a current carrying conductor which is kept in a uniform magnetic field. So uniform magnetic field is simply shown by the parallel lines, as it is shown in the diagram. This is the uniform magnetic field. Like we have already discussed with the electric field, uniform electric field. Similarly, we are using the uniform magnetic field, and of course we will be studying about the magnetic field lines in detail also in the coming lectures. So this is simply showing you the uniform magnetic field, and we are having a conductor which is a current carrying conductor with you. So it means it is carrying the current. So if I take the small element here dl, then I can take the idl is the small current element in this length. We are supposing length of the conductor as l. A we are taking as the area of cross section. And then what is the number of electrons in the dl element, in this small dl element? If I take that n is the number density of electrons. Number density of electrons means number of electrons per unit length. Small n we have always used for number of electrons per unit length, for l length. And for dl length, you have to simply multiply it with dl and a into dl. And now if you want to find the force which is experienced by the electrons in this dl element, that will be the small value of the force, that is df. And that will be nadl is what? Number of electrons. So q, if I want to take the total charge, that this number of electrons is to be multiplied with the electronic charge, and the charge on the electron is of course negative, minus of e. And this is your Vd into V, that is the direction for the velocity, drift velocity. And B, if you are taking, this is by the definition of the Lorentz magnetic force, that is Vd cross B. Now if you rewrite this formula, then what you are getting is that minus N, E, A and Vd, these are the fixed values. So I can write it in terms of the current element that is given by dl cross b. So this is your dl cross b, and this you have already studied in the previous chapter, that is neavd is nothing but the current, the value of the current which is there. So this you can replace by current. So the formula for the small force I'm getting, it is equals to IDL cross B. So I can write it in terms of your IL B sine theta. This is I current, and then L for the length, and then B sine theta. So you have to write it with your hand to make the things more clear in your mind. This is, if you have to see the direction again, you can see magnetic field is in this direction, and Vd is in this direction, that is giving you the direction, and then you have to find the direction of the force will be given by the direction of the thumb. So that you have to see that yours direction should be clear. Or again, it can be written in terms of dl cross b. And negative sign is simply showing that the direction of this dl is opposite to vd. VD is that drift velocity, and DL is the direction for the current element. That you have to keep it in your mind. So moving ahead, of course you can write it in the cross vector form. We want to find the force between two parallel infinitely long current carrying conductors. Now I am having two current conductors with me. Again, the experiment was done by the scientist Ampere by putting the charge carrying conductors in the mercury, and he made the arrangement to just produce the current in these wires. And current is produced in these wires, and then what was seen that if the current is made to pass in the same direction, then they attract each other, while if the current is made to flow in the opposite directions, then they repel each other. And this can be proved now with the help of mathematics. He performed this experiment, and again, by the knowledge of this, the definition of 1 ampere, the basic unit which you study in class 11th, is taken from this experiment which was performed by the scientist Ampere. It was there. So we have to find mathematically the value of these forces which will be acting, and why they are attracting or why they are repelling in different cases. We have to study in detail. So you, this is of course a very important question from your examination point of view, because many times they ask you to define 1 ampere in terms of the forces between the parallel current carrying conductors. So what we have to find is, we have to simply find the force between two parallel infinitely long current carrying conductors. Like, we are having these conductors which we have named as PQ, and another conductor is named as RS, and the current directions are also shown in the diagrams. I1 and I2 are the current. Now I am not showing the source of the current. Of course we have to connect it with the battery to make the current to pass. Now what it is, now if this is the current carrying conductor, I want to find the field due to this current carrying conductor at this wire at any point on RS. So what will be the magnetic field? That you can find by your previous knowledge of the right hand screw rule or right hand thumb rule. So if this is the current carrying, your point is lying here. So your point is coming, this direction is coming inward. So the magnetic field here on this point, R distance you may take, then at this point the magnetic field due to the first current carrying conductor is inward. So I'm showing it by the cross. Now I'm just focusing on this wire only. The force I want to find on this wire because of this PQ wire. Magnetic field I have seen. Of course, you can write the magnitude for the field by using the Biot-Savart law. That is, I'm calling it as V1, which is equals to mu naught I1 divided by 2 pi R. Now, what will be the value of the force? For finding force, you have to use the Fleming's left-hand rule, or you can use with the right-hand palm rule, your choice. So I'm using the left hand rule. If this is inward direction is for the your magnetic field, and this is the direction of the current, and this conductor is I2. So you have to take the direction of the current, and then you have to find the direction of the force. So what way the direction of the force is coming? This way, as you can see. So it is same means towards the wire. And you have find it by using the left hand rule. So this is the direction of the force, which is F on 2 due to 1. It means force on the second wire due to the first wire. Second wire I have taken as RS, first wire I have taken as PQ. So direction should be clear. So this is the direction of the force, and of course magnitude you all know by using this Lorentz force. You can write that is equals to V1. I, L, so I here is I2, and L I have written as L only, and sine 90, sine theta is 90 because 90 is the angle here you can see between the current and the magnetic field, the direction is theta is 90 degrees, so this angle theta will be taken as 90 degrees. So this will be the magnitude of the force which is on the wire RS due to PQ. And the direction is as shown in the diagram, that you have to understand how I have found that the direction. So firstly, you have to find the direction of B1 by using right hand thumb rule. Then you have to find the direction of F21 by using Fleming's left hand rule. So now this is the magnitude for F21, should be clear to you. L we have taken as the length of the conductor. Similarly, you people, of course, you can sine 90 because it is 1. You can simply write this formula as mu naught I1 I2 L upon 2 pi. Here, if you wish, you can write the formula F it is equals to your B I L sine theta. So here we have already explained the value of current is I2, length is L, and B1 is this. Same we have to write. And then you can simply work it out and you can write it like this. Now, same lines, you can find the magnetic force on PQ due to RS. So for that, of course, you will be writing the value of B2. B2 is the magnetic field on this wire because of this current carrying conductor in this I2. I2 is now the current carrying conductor. So this is current I want to find at this point. So this is coming to outward. So this is shown by the dot. So B2 is now outward. Now B2 is outward. You have to fix your left hand to find the direction of the force. So B2 is outward now, and this is the direction of the current. Then you can find the direction of the force, which is coming again towards RS. And if you want to write the magnitude for this magnetic field, of course, you have to use Biot-Siebert's law, that is mu naught I2 divided by 2 pi R. And if you have to write the force, then you have to use the Lorentz force, that is mu, this B2 and I1 current in this wire, and L sine theta. B2, I1, L sine theta. And B2 value we have written from here. So you can write these values and then you can simply work out with the things. So you can put the value of sine 90 and you are coming with F12 magnitude is mu naught I1 I2 L upon 2 pi R. Now if you want to write force F12 or F21, both the cases you can see the magnitudes are coming same. That is mu naught I1 I2 L upon 2 pi R. But directions are opposite. So you can simply write, if you want to write in vector form, you will be writing F12, it is equals to minus of F21, because directions are opposite, but magnitudes are same. So many times they find force per unit length of the conductor. You have to derive the expression for the force per unit length of the conductor, then simply divide it by the length. So force upon length is coming out to be mu naught I1 I2 upon 2 pi R. So of course unit will be Newton per meter. So this derivation is very important, many times asked that. So you should be very clear. I have taken both the cases in detail so that there should not be any confusion regarding anything. In this particular expression, of course, we have taken small r as the distance between the two conductors. That also should be clear. So wherever whatever thing is to mention, you should be mentioning all the things, and you should be able to understand the things, of course, so that further questions based on this also you should be able to do. Now, if you have two wires which are having the currents in the opposite directions like this, then if you want to find the force, this force's direction comes this way, pointing away from each other this way. So that is the reason when I ask you the question, that when the conductors, they are carrying the current in the same direction, they always attract each other, because we have already derived this case, first case we have already derived, we have seen. Similarly, if you see the direction of the forces for this case, then you will find the forces are coming in these directions, and hence they are repelling each other. So this part, you can find the directions yourself and you can verify for the things. And thus you can give it as the reason that why it is happening in this way. So very important, this is, you can be asked to define 1 ampere by the finding the force between two parallel conductors, current carrying conductors of this. So we are having the force per unit length, we have derived the expression, that is force per unit length is mu naught I1 I2 divided by 2 pi r. Now here if you take that current I1 and I2 are equals to 1 ampere, and this distance r between the current carrying conductors is also 1 meter. And of course, you know, mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. So if you put the values, this force is coming out to be 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 7 newton per meter. So it means you can define that 1 ampere is the current which, when passed through two parallel conductors of infinite length of 1 meter apart, they are kept 1 meter apart, of course they are placed in vacuum, they are experiencing a force of 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 7 newton per meter on each other. So it means this conductor is causing the force 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 newton per meter on this conductor, and the same is exerted here by this if the current is 1 ampere. So 1 ampere is that current which makes this much force to be exerted per unit length on the another wire which is kept 1 meter apart. So this is by the use of this formula. We have simply defined 1 ampere. This diagram is simply showing you the magnetic fields for your more awareness of the things, that when the current carrying conductors same direction, then how you want to show the magnetic field, and if they are carrying the current in opposite direction, then how you are supposed to show the magnetic field, and of course by using right hand. So directions are important all the time in this chapter. Direction is very important. So for finding field, for finding force, all the things should be very clear in your mind. And of course, we will be continuing in the next lecture for the further details of the things. Keep things up to this. Thank you, everyone.